上个月我被人压足了。是啊，我冲个红灯，大家我点啫？有冇伤到人？有冇死人先？差人话犯法喎，之后就讲笑咁问佢，咁我咪又要坐监啊？咁佢就话唔定你一日真系要去坐监，但系都唔似一个执犯嚟，所以今次就俾我走咗啦。于是我就喺度谂，如果我做一啲犯法嘅事，我唔系都要坐监嘅咩？虽然呢件事系犯法，但系呢样系咪唔道德或者好衰嘅嘢嚟？咁我究竟同在囚人士之间有咩分别呢？呢个对我嚟讲系一个谜，等我去揾下答案先。嗱，咁我咧就四个谜，四条问题需要去解答。咁第一，我冲咗红灯，咁当然我唔系惯犯啦，但系始终做咗啲犯法嘅事。咁个问题系，到底系咪每一个坐监嘅人都系衰人呢？我去咗揾 Timothy O'Leary 教授，去帮我解答呢个谜。究竟社会系点样睇在囚人士嘅呢？点解社会认为我哋呢啲正常人会同在囚人士有唔同嘅呢？以下就系佢根据 Michel Foucault 理论而讲嘅嘢。
I mean, I guess by definition, in some sense, they're seen as being abnormal because society has certain rules and regulations and laws, and most people seem to most of the time conform to those regulations and laws. People who don't fall outside of that and therefore, in some sense, by definition, are abnormal. Some of those people end up in things we call prisons,which are run by a Department of Corrective Services, so we have now have abnormal people in an institution which is going to correct them. In other words, one has to say in some sense the institution is going to return them to the norm, return them to the normal. And again, the point is that's not necessarily, you don't have to necessarily see that as a bad thing, but I guess the Foucault point would be that we should always bear in mind that those forms of normalization do have a dark side or a downside to them.
所以他们会被视为不正常。而传媒描写他们的时候，是不是都会认为他们是不正常的呢？曾经做过刑事案的洪运信律师尝试解释这个现象，或者不如我们一起去看看。
当然那个新闻的报道的自由是很重要的，无可否认。但是呢，我发觉呢，就其实很多时候香港呢，就是拉嗰陣時咧就好震撼㗎，啊張張報紙都講話呢個人俾人拉咗啦，咁樣咁。但有不幸嘅咧就係打完場官司判咗佢冇罪咧，係冇人報嘅喎。
咁所以傳媒係會影響我哋對拘捕人士嘅觀感。龐思訓教授仲講咗一個好得意嘅論點，就係我哋對於唔同嘅案件係有唔同嘅反應。我仲記得佢用咗一個好搞笑嘅比喻㗎。
And also it bothers me when I see the family members cheering or, you know, oh, justice has been done. Yes, yes. It reminds me of a sports game. You know, our team won. Yay, yay. You know, how can you compare the feeling of a person who committed a crime being put away to, you know, for, let's say, 10 years,in prison, to your favorite sports team winning the championship. And yet people react in very similar ways to those two kinds of situations.
我想我的谜题已经解开，就是永远都只得罪案和报复才会在刊登在头条，但是原谅和无辜是不会被人报道的。嗱，呢一条就有下一条问题。咁或者喺500年前，我应该都唔会被警察捉我冲红灯噶啦，因为嗰阵根本就冇红绿灯。咁历史有冇教过我哋，有啲嘢以前做系犯法，喺而家或者将来做系唔犯法嘅呢？ 不如你估下，究竟同性性行为、同性婚姻同埋偷嘢，竟有咩共通点呢？唔识啊？咁就要请 Timothy O'Leary 为我哋解开呢个问题啦。
In many jurisdictions up until fairly recently, it was illegal to engage in sodomy, which is sometimes seen as being an anti-gay legislation or making homosexuality illegal. It's not exactly that. I mean, it's different from that. So, nevertheless, it could be used and was used in that in as a means of attempting to control gay men. And their sexual activities. So that there was a sexual act which was against the law. In fact, it was a criminal act. So that's something that, I mean, today, in most places, those laws have been repealed in most parts of the world, I believe. So that's it's no longer illegal to do that. Of course, there are certain other forms of behavior, maybe related to sexuality, which are illegal, but not that one. So I think that that's an example of something that, you know, at one point, was criminalized because people had a moral condemnation of it.
除了同性性行为和同性婚姻之外，究竟做了什么以前是犯法的呢？那就不如由洪运信律师为我们解答有哪些罪案以前可以犯法了。
如果没记得70年代呢，自杀是犯法的，是犯刑法的。我不知道當時要不要坐監，因為我都未做律師嘅，嗰陣時仲讀緊小學嚇。咁、但我好肯定，我而家知道咧，就係以前係一個刑事法嚟嘅。另外咧就係、是、通奸 adultery 啊，我相信咧好多四五十年前啩，咁咧 adultery 曾幾何時係一個 criminal offence 嚟㗎。咁點解你話而家冇咗咧？咁我嘅估計嗱，我唔知道確實嘅原因嘅，但係我嘅估計咧就係因為社會上嗰個轉變啊，但係今時今日唔係咁睇噶嘛。咁我可能覺得係道德上嗰個尺度咧放寬咗，咁所以令到咧立法嗰方面咧係要將。其實通奸咧就非刑事化，咁自殺咧就其實我覺得原則上唔係好啱嘅，即係佢想死，佢死唔去，你先告得佢嘅啫，係咪？咁你又要罰佢，因為佢自己想死喎，即係我覺得係唔係好合邏輯？
哇！咁佢嗰陣都幾 out 嘅喎。不知300年之後會不會有人跟我們一樣都會說同一句話呢？洪運信律師跟我們說過，法律是需要與時並進
的。另外一件事，現在 Law Reform Commission 是在看的呢，就是將所有sexual offense 風化的控罪呢，就由頭到尾再看一次，因為由某些的控罪可能已經過時，某啲嘅控罪咧係需要與時並進嚇，咁、要收呢個 example 嚟啦，即係 rape 強姦咧係只係男人強姦女人嘅啫喎，咁而家嘅強姦嘅控罪咧係好簡單啫，即係除咗個意圖之外咧，就係話男嘅性器官嚇、要掂到女嘅性器官或者。插入咗，咁但係如果我即係有啲情況咧，就如果嗰個男嘅係用硬物咧，係咪？咁但係如果喺而家嚟講，呢個唔係強姦嚟嘅喎，咁但係即係我自己睇，其實冇分別嘅喎，係咪？咁點解而家嘅控罪係要 exclude 咗呢啲咁嘅即係呢啲咁嘅 violence 嘅 attack 咧？即係有可能，因為而家咧係比較窄啲嘅，啊，咁有啲問題喺度嘅，即係我覺得咧係應該要即係提一次嚇。
對於呢個問題，究竟歷史又可唔可以話俾我哋知邊啲人先需要坐監咧？ 我只可以话，如果今时今日通奸都仍然系一个罪嘅话，咁我谂起再多嘅监狱都唔够啦，系嘛？哦，咁唔怪法律成日都会改变啦。如果有一日我当有人冲红灯嘅话，咁佢系咪要俾人拉去坐监先？如果我哋俾人拉嘅话，我第一件事就系需要一个律师，系差馆有律师嘅可。
即如果你问我嘅，就最好嘅办法咧，就系当涉及一件刑事案，而家差人敲门啊，或者话要拉要锁啦，咁其实嗰阵时咧就应该系。盡量諮即係有機會嘅話，可以諮詢法律意見咯。啊，咁我明白咧，就唔係個個人都識個律師噶嘛，亦都唔係個個律師都做刑事案嘅。咁但係即係而家嘅制度，即係冇解救咯。我知道法律援助局同埋政府係磋商緊咧，係應唔應該喺差館度咧？最少成立一啲法律諮詢嘅熱線，咁即係話咧，嗰個被拉嗰個人咧，起碼可以拎起個電話去問一個律師基本嘅法律意見。
咩話？冇免費律師？咁我咪應該唔出聲啊？喂，我唔講嘢我會死嘅喎！如果遲啲啲法律改咗嘅話，咁我諗我都要坐監啦，係嘛？然后冲红灯嗰啲人亦都会俾人拉，咁但系我可以上诉噶嘛，系咪先？我好肯定，我可以俾到一个好合理嘅解释，点解我会冲红灯？喂，大佬，我赶时间嘅，咁之后我都只系要揾一个律师帮我辩护啫，轻松啦。
一般嚟讲，系申请法援系唔难嘅。香港嘅法援咧，其实咧就系好。generous 好真係好大方，尤其是刑事嘅，因為刑事咧，全世界即係起碼香港人知道咧，係涉及嗰個人身自由啊！我已經講好多次啦，你一經被定罪，你就好大機會要坐監嘅。咁所以咧，去申請法援係刑事嘅法援咧，係較為容易嘅。咁但係咧，因為法援咧係用緊公堂，咁即係話咧，你自己請個律師，你有錢俾個律師，個律師話俾你聽，喂，其實你得10% 機會嘅啫喎，機會好細嘅啫喎，能夠推翻個定罪，但你話錢唔係問題，照做啦，去搏一搏啦，咁個律師咪有責任去做咯。咁但係法援咧，因為使緊公堂啊。咁佢唔能夠咧，就即係佢哋要衡量下件案嘅我哋叫 merits， 即係話嗰個證供係點樣啊？即係佢唔能夠咧就話啊50-50即係有機會贏50% 有機會贏50% 有機會輸都俾你啦法援。其實咁就唔得嘅，因為佢使緊公堂。
我諗我得到答案啦，冇錯，我係假定冇罪。但是要找到一个律师都很难的。回去原本我们的问题，在道德层面上，我们不是比在囚人士更加优越吗？但其实我们跟在囚人士之间是没有任何分别的。对于我们是不是罪人这条问题，当涉及是否罪、是否道德的时候，我想我应该要去天主教香港教区找秘书长李亮神父倾下偈。我想他应该可以给到答案我。
有些有罪人呢就是被监禁的，在监狱里面。有些呢 是犯了罪人呢就没有被监禁，是有出面社会大众自由生的那些。区别就是说，即是说呢有些人在铁窗里面，那些是呢啲啲被囚禁嗰啲人，佢哋係罪人。但有啲罪人咧係唔喺鐵窗裏邊嘅，喺出邊嘅自由行動啊，嗰啲都係罪人。嚇，聽明意思嚇？ 咁但係唔係你大啲罪嗰啲啊？好難講啦，有時咧，有啲人犯好多罪，嗰出面咧冇監喺度，但可能犯罪嘅犯嗰啲過錯，對社會損害大過坐緊監啲人嘅先，係咪或者等同都好嚇、啊，或者我唔係咁多都好少都，但我仍然咧，我冇機會，我唔啱捉我唔到，我冇坐監佢啦。即使話所有嘅人都是罪人嚇、啊、不過有啲人咧，因為咧係觸犯法紀嚇、啊，即係都係坐事啦。因為法律上嘅要求咧，嗰位咧就咧佢咧係坐監，被判坐監。
OK。我是罪人了，得未啊？但系同真正犯罪的人一定有分别咯，系咪先？我揾旁师瞓觉就睇下会唔会得到答案啦。
The main difference, I think, is the prisoners got caught. but other than that, there's not. I don't believe that there's any kind of essential moral difference or difference in our nature or anything like that. I think there are some people who think that some people are kind of born good and some people are born evil, and you know, the prisoners are the unlucky ones who were born to be bad. But I believe that all human beings have basically the same nature, and the thing in prisoners that caused them to do what they did and then get caught is basically something that we all share.
Okay.
So my answer is no, I don't think that there's any kind of essential difference. I think the main difference between someone who beats up a person and someone who doesn't is that they acted out their desire, and most of us don't act out our desires most of the time. And so the question there is, from a moral point of view, is there any essential difference between somebody who acts on their desire and someone who doesn't act on their desire? So what makes us good or evil? Is it what we desire in our heart, or is it what we do? There's an argument that could be made that the person who does what they desire is actually more honest. And honesty is an important part of moral character. So I'm not trying to defend someone who beats somebody up. I mean, I would rather have someone think about beating me up than actually beat me up. Most people, I think, would agree that honesty and courage are good human character traits. And there's a lot of prisoners, I think, that are more honest and more courageous than people who will never be in prison. But the reason that people who aren't will never be in prison and won't be in prison isn't that they're better persons. It's more that they're dishonest or cowards. And so they're not willing to act on the desires that they have.
Well, that's quite provocative. So you're saying that prisoners are better morally or more virtuous?
I wouldn't say they're better, but I do think that I think there's more than one way to define goodness, and that each person and each situation is good in some ways and evil in some ways. And we tend to be too simplistic in our understanding of good and evil. Many times we tend to view it just in terms of the law. You know, a good person is a person who doesn't break the law. An evil person is a person who breaks the law.
雖然我是一個罪人，但都不是一個十惡不赦的惡魔啊。哇！即刻松咗一口气，我哋将来仲有希望啊！去到最后，我就去咗揾 Tobias Brenner， 佢一定会知道关于在囚人士嘅嘢。话晒佢探咗班囚犯都探咗成廿年啦，佢肯定会知道我哋同在囚人士之间唔同嘅嘢。犯罪嘅人就系罪人，咁唔通我哋天使咩？或者我哋不如听下佢想讲啲咩啊？
即係佢哋係當中係佢哋所做嘅當中，佢哋又係做壞事。但係佢哋唔係因為做過一次、兩次、幾次可能壞事，佢哋係等於係一個壞人。我哋都係有時你有時我哋做壞啲壞唔好唔係咁好嘅事，但係呢個又唔係我哋嘅全部嘅實際。
實在太好啦！我同咗咁多人講嘢之後，終於都可以解答到一切所有嘅謎題。其实我哋同在囚人士之间都唔系真系好唔同嘅， 我哋冇一个人系完全无辜嘅，我哋大家都面对紧同样嘅挑战，就系、是、为自己所做嘅一切负上责任。就睇下我可唔可以控制自己唔冲红灯，呢、这个真系一个好大嘅挑战。我仲记得有一日，我经过一间好旧嘅戏院，嗰度仲播紧《无间道》添。我回想翻，我都好耐冇再嚟过呢种咁旧嘅戏院啦。我好中意坐喺戏院入边，被黑暗包围住，同好多唔识嘅人坐埋一齐，望住个大荧幕，就觉得自己好似去咗第二个世界咁。《无间道》呢一套戏系讲一个警察。去黑社会做卧底，同一个古惑仔去做警察嘅故事。咁我嗰阵就喺度谂啦，如果我都做咗好耐卧底嘅话，我又会唔会质疑自己嘅身份呢？我又会迷失咗自己呢？喺解决咗呢四个谜之后，我明白到其实在囚人士同我哋系冇咩分别嘅，冇人会净系得好嘅一面，亦都冇人系净系得坏嘅一面。我就开始喺度谂，喺我哋嘅文化面。例如藝術、電影、文學等等，到底他們是怎樣描寫罪呢？好和壞呢？到底是否所有東西都像童話故事那樣黑白分明呢？是否好人一定只有好的一面，壞人就只有壞的一面呢？既然是這樣，那讓我一語打給香港國際電影節協會經藝術總監李卓圖去找一下答案吧。據我所知，他已經對香港電影已經是十分之了解了。咁所以我想問下他啦，到底香港電影入邊所飾演警察嘅係咪一定係好人，而古惑仔係咪一定係衰人呢？
咁其實咧，黑社會片咧，好似即係為咗其實為咗戲劇性咧，咁就係、是、因為戲劇性係一種。都會吸引嘅嘢咧，好時候都一定好多時候咧唔會所有黑社會中人都係一副就係奸人咁嘅樣，因為嗰時五百幾多奸都淨係對男嘅就可能警察就打劫住嘅，中其實嗰種戲劇性咧係比較薄弱嘅，太簡單。咁咧多數咧警察入邊咧有啲好啲，有啲衰啲啲社會入邊咧啲主角咧可能咧有啲好啲，即係一定有。同嘅即係所性格啊，一個背景啊，咁呢啲係戲劇性咯。咁而寫出嚟嗰啲時候，可能比較係有人性啲嘅啊，即係唔係話淨係黑到好犀利嘅，即係嗰啲黑幫人物嚟講咧，可能其實都係為咗呢個目的，而唔見得佢或者係會探討到佢即係真係作為一個普通人，普通人嘅普通人性嗰面。如果最多咧，就只係話，譬如話，佢哋都有
家人啦，啊，有啊，佢都係好時候啲北方咧好孝順阿媽嘅，啊，咁咧對個老婆好嘅，啊，當然佢同出邊可能有情婦嘅，啊，咁但係對啲仔女咧好錫嘅喎，即係咁令到佢咁好時候成日出現啲戲劇性表演，咁佢個老婆啊或者仔女俾人捉咗去要挟佢啦，咁佢嘅佢會不惜一切唔要自己條命都要救佢哋啊，即係呢啲咪真係戲劇性嘅嘢。
中最初係部明明英雄本色開始，大家都聽。呢個都聽過啦，咁咧咁話啊，當然大家最記得可能係周潤發嗰個歌嘅造型啊，對白啊，或者某啲場面啊，但其實大家好唔記得，其實主角咧，起碼佢原本啊改編自1967年陸光導演嗰部《英雄本色》咧，個主角其實係啊狄龍嚟嘅，即係啊1986年嘅部啊吳宇森嘅《英雄本色》咧，狄龍呢個角色咧，其實就係一個坐監出嚟嘅色情想。回歸社會，但係處處受到即係以前啲兄弟啊，或者依家新升嘅大佬啊，咁啊同埋啊呢、這個差人對佢又唔信任，種種啊壓迫同埋仲有啦，跟住新版啊改咗佢細佬啦，張國榮飾演嘅係警察添。咁你諗下，細佬警察大哥係個以前嘅大佬，咁、那個又係強加強好多嘅戲劇性咯，即係嗰樣嘢。嗰陣時咧，五六成就粵語片咧係多啲所謂文藝片啊，就算係通俗劇都好啦，啊，都其實係對寫呢啲人情人性嘅嘢咧係來比較重點，而唔係只係黑道後來嘅啲嘢。係啦，咁你跟住呢個英雄式瘋狂賣座之後咧，就多咗好多所謂英雄片。其實英雄片咧就係黑幫片嚟嘅。只不過即係都係主角社會大佬，不過咧係好英雄啊！跟所以大家叫因為英雄片識個片名啦，咁好多時候叫個片咧都用英雄呢樣嘢咁睇佢英雄片。咁嚟嗰啲黑幫片話咯，好多時候啲大佬咧都係頭先我講嗰只咯，即係佢啲嗰個語片名咩英雄好漢啊、江湖情啊，或者就好多嘅呢啲字本流言啊，好多呢啲咁嘅片都係啊咁。一定有個幾好嘅社會大
哥。哇！我真係暈。呢個香港電影歷史之旅真係好精彩咯。我估電影同現實生活中應該都係冇可能黑白分明噶啦。如果世界真係咁黑白分明嘅話，咁咪好悶咯。如果電影入面冇嘢係黑白分明嘅話，咁我就喺度諗文學作品都一樣嘅啫。好。有咁多唔同类型嘅文学作品，等我又吓下自己先。到底有咩人会想喺文学作品入面睇到关于纯洁同埋神圣嘅嘢呢？除非你睇紧神学文献啦。好，捉实你顶帽，等我哋一齐由电影世界出发去文学同埋神学嘅世界啦。等我去揾下天主教香港教区嘅秘书长李亮神父去解答我嘅疑难先。佢提及过圣思定嘅一本叫做《忏悔录》嘅文学作品。咁究竟佢一个点样嘅人？而佢身为一个虔诚嘅基督徒，又有啲乜嘢要剖白呢？
啊，就是 Augustine 啦，喂，呢个喺大概系咧，佢我记得佢就咧，佢出生嘅年期啦吓，佢在世70几年啦，就佢喺北非度出世噶，北非出生噶，系喺公元354年啊，至到430啊。354至430啊，因為即係76歲左右就去世。咁佢即係佢係一個係啊，佢就當初係一個外教人嚟噶，冇唔係基督徒嚟。後來咧，佢歸依咗基督徒啦嚇，認咗世啦。咁就咧後來咧就成為一個即係一個隱修士咁樣嚇。就喺啲隱修，然後咧就成為咗，就再後來咧就成為一個主教啊，即係被立為一個主教啊，大會主教啊。咁一嚟就喺自己擔當自己主教職務咧，一直到去世為止啊。咁咧做主教咧成咧係成將近40年咁上下時間啦。佢個呢位聖人咧，佢係一個好著名嘅一個學者嚟啊。喺我哋教會裏邊咧有詩嚟啊，天主教會裏邊一個基督徒嘅歷史當中係咧。呢個咧係數一數，呢個係嗰幾位係幾位最著名嘅神學家之一嚇，最著名嘅神學家之一嚇，佢係影響力好大啊，喺啲後代啊，影響力好大噶。咁同有啲神學家都係啦嚇，係嗰幾位最影響力最大嘅嚇，最著名嘅神學家之一嚇。
好，暫時都幾好啦。咁佢一定係有一個清白嘅人生啊，好。
呢、这個佢本書咧寫咗十三章嘅書啊，佢係講自己成個皈依過程嘅書啊，用個總括嚟講，佢自己點樣由一個外教人啊，一個係摸索緊信仰人生意義嘅人啦嚇，係、自己係咧轉轉折折啊好崎嶇曲折咁走咗道路，又信一啲冇啲啊，跟住啲啊哲學學派啊嚇，啊跟住啲嗰啲其他啲宗教啲咁啊，摸索摸索之後咧嚇啊，終於係咧自己。歸到悟出咗喺天主嘅光度之下，悟出咗自己啊，應該係成個基督徒啊，持守基督信仰，於是咧係領洗歸依咁嚇。咁你啊，我認得你太過遲啦，認識你太過遲啦，知先嘛？啊，我真係後悔啊！我當初行咁崎嶇道路，犯咁多罪過，咁遲先至啊，即係咁後先認得到你。之後如果我早啲就好啲咯，認識你嚇。佢哋認個朋友又好似有時講笑嚇，人哋一個男朋友認識個女朋友又話：哎呀，我早啲，哎唔使認識咁多人啦，你先係我最心愛嘅人啊！哎，認識你早啲，哎太遲啦！哎，嗰啲女嗰啲朋友都唔夠啊！嚇，而家你先係最好噶，我最嚇最嚇最認個最最心愛嘅人啊！嗰個朋友嚇咁啊，而家太遲咯，早啲就好啲嚇。我咁講啊，呢啲係一種嘅回顧、反省嚇、懺悔、後悔嚇，然後一種讚美天主、感恩、感恩嚇、感恩讚美。咁所以呢個人包括曬呢在內。
我想我们每一个人都曾经走过一段充满荆棘的路，在过程里面我们不停地去寻找自己的出路，不停地努力去令自己变得更加好，而我们可以做的就只是可以尽力做到最好。那我就在想，黑社会、警察和圣司定主教圣司都是差不多的，都是没有人是完全是好人或者完全是坏人。我不禁就在想，难道我们全部都是一样的？会不会是这样啊？我一定会找到答案的。这个真是一个很哲学性的问题啊。啊，不是有个哲学家叫伊曼努尔·康德的吗？他讲过关于一些道德哲学的东西的。我去完天主教香港教区之后，就立刻打了去香港浸会大学找哲学系教授庞思奋，请他为我介绍一下伊曼努尔·康德这个人。OK 的，他讲了三个钟头而已，轻松，不用问他一定是专家了。哇，根本恶，这个字听起来真的，哇，恐怖。
Kant claims that every single human being, without exception, starts out life not taking responsibility for what they do. But instead, we start out life basically like animals.We start out life with our animality on top and our comparison with other human beings next and kind of driving our animality so that our desire for happiness is fueled. It's like our comparison, our rational ability to compare ourselves with each other fuels this desire from our animality. So we get hungrier when we see somebody else eating a lot, and we get...jealous when we see someone winning a prize that we think we should have won, or whatever it might be, And then Kant argues that the typical human being, not just typical, he argues that every human being, at the outset of their moral development, doesn't care about personal responsibility. Now, he does argue later in the book that education is key.That we need to educate people to make them recognize their moral responsibility, to get them to realize it's not just about getting caught, but it's about being a good person in your heart. And being a good person in your heart means taking responsibility for what you do. Okay? So in part one of this book, Religion Within the Bounds of Bare Reason, Kant's basic argument is there's a huge problem in human nature.And that is, the problem in human nature is that we are all made to be good. Our nature is such that our nature gives us this potential to be good and to do good, to be good and to do good. So being good is the ethical part. Doing good is the legal part, okay? But we don't do it. We have this natural tendency, he calls it the propensity to evil.Okay, that's his key principle. And the propensity to evil makes us radically evil. Now, I'll say one more thing about that, and then I'll briefly explain what he does in the other parts of the book. So, radical evil, which is the kind of his conclusion in part one, human nature is radically evil. That's his conclusion. That claim is sometimes misunderstood by people who read the book, because people think, oh, radical evil means we're all Hitler. We're all like Hitler, you know, or we're all like the murderers who live in prison. Well, in a sense, that is his theory. But radical, the radical in radical evil does not mean super, super, super evil. What it means is every human being at the ground level of their personality, you know, at the kind of basis of your moral character, in the deepest part of your heart, has the same desire to do something to make you happy and avoid responsibility. Okay, that's what radical evil means. And his argument is, all of us have that. Radical means it's right there at the root. Radical comes from a Latin word, radix, which means the root. Okay, so if you think of human nature as being like a plant, then radical evil is the theory that right there at the root of the plant, there's a disease that threatens to make the plant unhealthy. And that's what makes people do bad things, Kant thinks. His argument is that, you know, none of us are innocent. So this is, he doesn't mention prisoners anywhere in the book, as far as I can remember. But I'm quite certain that if asked, Kant would have replied by saying, oh, from a moral point of view, there's no difference at all between a prisoner and us. There's no difference between Hitler and me. The only difference, I mean, at a moral level, the only real difference is that I and the prisoner, or I and Hitler, were in a different life situation, and maybe I got lucky. You know.
听落去，亲爱的自我好似好听过金本乐噃，但系金本乐听落又好似正啲。
And one more thing, by the way, he says radical evil is especially problematic because it makes every human being self-deceptive. So one of the, this is kind of psychological more than philosophical, but it also makes a very important philosophical point. And his point is, radical evil causes us to think better of ourselves than we really are. So this is part of his theory about what every human being shares. The prisoner usually thinks, I'm not as bad as my punishment. You know, I shouldn't be punished this badly, because what I did wasn't as bad as what they're saying that I did. You know? But we're not any different, because when we do something a little bit wrong, you know, when we lie, or you know, somebody wants us to help them but we don't help, we usually think, oh, but I'm still a good person. You know, the point being, Kant argues that we've got this deeply rooted tendency to deceive ourselves. He calls it the dear self. He says we always think highly of the dear self, and we often just don't realize how bad we really are.
呢啲嘢好似哲學喎，咁總括嚟講，再點冇？
You can see that when it relates to the situation the prisoners are in, the message really is that every human being is in the same situation, and we are all faced with the same challenge. Prisoners no different than anyone else. And the challenge is, stop fooling yourself into thinking that by seeking after your own personal happiness, that doing that is to be a good person. But rather, take responsibility for what you've done, for the bad things that you've done, and seek to improve yourself to the best of your ability.
听咗咁多之后，等我问翻天主教香港教区嘅秘书长李亮神父先。如果我哋每一个人都一样，都系罪人嘅话，咁我哋可以做啲咩咧？ 是不是只要我们忏悔就会没事的呢？
反省省察、就是呢是愿意定改定意识决定是改即决志去改过千改过千善改过自身，然后呢是去告明的神好处，办告解，办告解即是办办理办告告明自己过失，神给你少许免给保赎你、然后呢你呢就给祝福你赦罪和祝福，而你呢去完成你的保赎，而呢要有一个新的开始来生活，离弃以前那些坏的习惯罪那些、新的开始、免疫行事好啊，你做人是免疫的过失的嘛，人间不要一次过就搞定了，所以对隔一段时间你最后你见到回、我神父我呢上一次拜会的时候呢、有些地方我改善了，但有些都未得、都未改善，或者、这个碰到、逆不幸我自己又犯了没有其他过失要告明嘛，就说这个周而复始不断去这样去呢改善，那你有没有作用呢？有些、其他的信徒有些宗派说、这些是、什么形式上的东西，是不是这样说是改善就改善，是不是形式上的神会办告解做什么形式上的、其实我们不拗太多先，现在不可以说不是讲一些上的教育课程这个是有帮助 有帮助的，因为呢当我们每一次这个人参加这个我叫仪式这个告罪的仪式的时候呢神父代表天主是赦罪的，代表赦罪的，而同时是天主透过这个神父是通传一些恩宠祝福给这个是那个告罪的教育，所以他有一个新的开始，有能力上，所以这个办告的时候都有一些恩宠助佑给这个参加例如这个仪式的人。
OK OK， 等我都去忏悔先。但是我可以去哪里忏悔呢？天主教香港教区秘书长李亮神父跟我说过，说我可以去忏悔题目，咁就係我应该用边种方式去忏悔呢？面对面好，匿名咁样去忏悔好，定去忏悔庭好呢？哇，咁多选择真係好难揀啊。
在最初期教會時候，在初世紀，我知道最早的那幾世紀基督徒即係教會創立之後呢，初期呢冇需要告解庭嘅，冇 confession 呢啲呢個咁嘅設計嘅時候，當時咧做嗰啲咧，通常喺邊係要告罪，向邊個告罪咧？唔向神，唔向司代啊，變成向主教嘅。點解咁講嘅咧？因為主教咧係負責所有啲嘅呢啲嘅宗教儀式，所有嗰個負責人嘅嚇，明先嚇係主教。主教幫人洗禮，主要洗禮，又幫人主持嗰個叫做係聖餐禮嚇，死人未殺啊嘛。主教幫人哋咧去親自探訪啲教徒。知道第二到第六個世紀到下世咧，我哋基督徒咧嚇一個係拜一次告解嘅，一生拜一次嘅。啊點解？因為總結性咁樣係一次嘅嚇，冇話咧係每年裏邊就幾個月啊一次啊啲啊啲冇啲嚇。所以係咁而通常咧嗰啲係犯得好嚴重過失嘅嚇，通奸啊強姦罪過、通奸罪過啦嚇、殺人呢啲咁嚇。到呢個中古時期時咧，或者慢慢教會發展嘅時候咧，由於咧呢啲嘅告解嘅次數係多咗嘅。每個信徒多咗啲嚇，至少咧唔單一次喎，你都要經常係檢討翻。我做丈夫嘅，做太太嘅，我會盡責喺婚姻生活裏邊啊。我自己都檢討生活啊。我係喺公司裏邊做嘢，我哋同事喺合作上，我點㗎？我係咪好認真做嘢啊？你點點啊？好啊，我誠誠實實做啊。啊，依或者對啲仔女話，我教育有教，會盡自己父母責任先啦。咁你一定要檢討啊嘛。嗰陣咧，一間設一個木箱啊，大木箱啦，啊木嘅設計，咁就通常咧喺嗰時候就坐喺裏邊啊，正中上側邊咧，兩邊咧就係咧可以啲係有少少一塊板嘅啦，兩邊嚇坐喺右邊咧，就嗰啲告罪啲教友咧就係、是、跪喺其中一邊嗰處嚇，咁而咧神父就將嗰個只係對向左少少嘅板罩咧，咁、那個板嗰處咧兩邊嘅板隔開咗，同嗰個信徒啊都係睇唔到嘅，然後中間有個少少嘅窗咁樣嚇。拉喺咗個窗算咁樣，咁就咧係一聽到嗰個人報名啊！但係咁你話個窗係咪望到個人邊話都望唔到嘅？嗱，啲有少少窿嘅喺處啊，即係聽到聲，但係睇唔到人嘅面貌好清楚啊！即係知道個人喺處下，但係咧我哋睇唔到人嘅樣貌喺處，其實咁呢個都係一保密。
如果頭先聽完有關電影同參悔嘅歷史之後都冇暈低嘅話，咁不如我哋一齊去聽下。Timothy O'Leary 教授所讲的一本由 Michel Foucault 所写的关于囚犯的书，而本书就叫做《愧愤与惩罚》。好嬲啦，真系最后一次同你讲历史啦！听完呢段之后，就真的会放弃到噶啦。监狱的历史 包括好聽。
Modern prison really is born around 1800. Before that, there were things that we might call prisons, but they were rather different. Before that, you were locked up in a dungeon, perhaps, and that was it. You were left alone to die. Whereas a modern prison, of course, is a very different rationale, different theoretical justification. And really, that's, I think, encapsulated in the fact that most modern prison systems, government departments, are called departments of corrective services, and that really is one of the key elements that Foucault identifies as this idea of correction. So discipline is a form of power that corrects individuals. In other words, it's a form of power that makes people into a certain kind of individual. So the prison is born around the same time, and the prison has certain features that are similar. Basically, the idea being that the government, the state, is taking individuals who are in some way corrupt, morally corrupt, and is trying to correct them to make them into a different kind of person, and then ideally, according to the theory, will then release them back into the community to be law-abiding citizens. So that's a modern idea, 18th, 19th century and 20th century idea of what the prison is for. So the prisons, ostensibly, they're not really there to punish people, they're there to make people better. At least that's what they say.
不好意思喎，那監獄同百貨公司有咩相同嘅地方呢？其實我哋會唔會都係困住喺百貨公司入面，俾人逼去買嘢呢？
So the Panopticon was a design for a building that was devised by Jeremy Bentham, who was an English philosopher at the very end of the 18th century. So I think it was about 1790, 1792. And the panopticon, as the word means in Latin, it means all-seeing, so everything is visible. And that's a model that's used in many different architectural forms, but one of its applications was in the prison. So what's the first thing the prison does, or one of the essential things the prison, at least the traditional 19th century, 20th century prison does, is it exposes the inmate to permanent visibility. And when you know you are being permanently watched, this will have an effect on your behavior. Now, another application of that principle is in, for instance, in the design of department stores. You might notice department stores have a lot of mirrors. They tend to have a lot of reflective surfaces. One of the reasons for that, of course, it makes for a very bright atmosphere, which might encourage you to do your shopping. But one of the reasons is also that you feel that you are constantly visible. Why is that a good thing in a department store? Because it reduces the chance of shoplifting. If you feel that you are being watched all the time, your behavior will change. So the prison is one institution, is an institution in which observability is in a very pure form.
嗱，究竟教育制度同埋監獄有咩相同嘅地方咧？我啊真系唔知啦。監獄本身就是用来教育人的。如果是这样的话，那学校不好像监狱咯。
So, on the day that a person is sentenced to prison, that's the judgment, right, in the court. But then once you arrive in a prison, there are lots of other judgments. You might be sent to solitary confinement. You might have your exercise privileges taken away or extended. You might be allowed to study. You might be allowed access to library or have a blocked. You might get parole, you might not, you might have certain visits, you might not. And all of those are done, the prison staff themselves make those little judgments on what kind of freedoms you can have within the prison. Similarly, in educational institutions, you have a constant observation, accumulation of information, and constant judgment of students' performance within a university and in a school. And also, a constant, what Foucault talks about as a form of normalization. So we think, for instance, about, well, you know, this primary year three kid should be able to do certain things. Any normal child of age 8 should be able to do certain things. Some children will be outside of that range. And then the educational apparatus has to do something about that. So it will try to correct. Right, so it tries to make sure that as many as possible of the children are within the normal range. If there are outliers, then they will be corrected. Similar things happen in prisons in terms of people's behavior. There's a certain norms are being instilled and being enforced. It has the effect of bringing a lot of attention upon what is now defined as being abnormal, right? So the abnormal becomes a kind of an affront. It's a kind of an insult to the normal, and something has to be done about it. So if people are outside of the normal range, especially if they are conceived as being in some way below the normal range, then they come in for a lot of special attention, with the idea being that, or at least sometimes the idea being that one ought to be within the normal range, that being outside of it is a problem, and it's a problem that needs to be corrected for.
同晒咁多位专家倾偈之后，我都认为世上系冇可能黑白分明嘅。我哋每个人其实都一样，都系处于好同坏之间嘅啫。